Dr. Rod Hall alerted all the veterinarians and everybody in the state that there has been a case of vesicular stomatitis virus found in Tillman County down in southwestern Oklahoma. There's been an outbreak in the United States. It began in June, around the 21st, in Texas. Texas, New Mexico, Colorado, and Wyoming have all got cases of vesicular stomatitis virus. Primarily in horses, but there has been one herd of cattle infected in Colorado. This is the first outbreak we've had since 2015. That was the last one in the United States.
And this is actually the first case that they've found in Oklahoma since like the 1990s, right?
That's right. We haven't had a case since sometime in the 1990s. We've been pretty lucky not to have had any, although there's been other outbreaks throughout the years, sporadically in nature in the United States.
So what exactly is vesicular stomatitis?
Well, it is a virus that infects, as I said, primarily horses and cattle, but it can infect other animals such as sheep, goat, alpacas, llamas, deer, or animals in the deer family. Usually what we're going to see is an animal's going to get a fever if you're really observant, but probably the first thing that owners would see would be drooling, and then they're going to start to see that there's some types of either blisters or ulcers around the mouth, tongue, gums. You may see it in the ears, legs, coronary bands of the horse's hooves, and occasionally on the genitalia and on the mammary glands as well.
So how exactly does this virus spread?
We're not exactly sure. We think that as far as that insects play a role in it, and then as far as once it's in animals, it'll spread from animal to animal as they come in contact with that saliva or those vesicles where that virus is. It can spread to just about any of our food animals, which is concerning for us. It's one of the reasons that we get all upset about the vesicular stomatitis virus, because if we see it in our food animals, we can't differentiate this from a lot of our foreign animal diseases like foot and mouth disease or swine vesicular disease. The only way we can tell the difference is through testing, laboratory testing. So that's why the state and federal authorities get concerned when they start to see this disease in our animals.
And when it comes to treatment, what are some things, if you know a producer does have come across an animal that's sick, what are some things that measures they can take to help treat this?
Well, unfortunately, it's a virus, and we don't have any antiviral drugs for this particular virus. So it's going to run its course, usually 10 to 14 days. During that time, though, these animals are in a lot of pain, usually. So they're reluctant to eat or drink, so we want to make sure that we soften up their food that they're going to eat, whether that be grain or hay or whatever. We want it to be soft. We're going to make sure they get plenty of water. We want them to rest. Veterinarians are probably going to prescribe some type of painkiller to ease their pain. And the other thing we might do, if we worry about secondary bacterial infections, we may give these animals some antibiotics.
When it comes to prevention, is there any prevention, you know, methods that producers can use as well?
Unfortunately, there's no vaccine for the disease. So our prevention revolves around biosecurity, you know, being careful about if we purchase a new animal, about introducing that into herd. We want it to be isolated for probably 30 days, make sure it doesn't have any signs of illness. We want to be sure if we get an animal sick in our herds, that we get that animal out, and isolate it from the rest of the herd, hopefully preventing spread of the disease. You really want to be careful. If you've got several horses, try to feed them and water them in individual buckets so that we don't spread. If you get one of them sick, you're not going to spread it from one animal to the next. And control the insects. That seems to be a part of this disease. We want to do everything we can to control those insects. In horses, you may think about putting them up at, you know, keeping them up at times when we know these biting insects are out, which is usually around dawn and dusk, if we could keep them in their stalls, especially if we've got screens on that barn so that no insects can get in there. That may help us prevent this disease from spreading or getting into your herd in the first place.
All right, thanks, Barry. If you would like some more information on vesicular stomatitis, go to our website, sunup.okstate.edu.